وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله الذي شرح صدور أوليائه بالإيمان وفتح لهم أبواب النصوص بقواعد البيان، وصلى الله وسلم على من أنزل الله عليه الكتاب والميزان وعلى آله وصحابته ومن تبعهم بإحسان، أما بعد. العام، the author رحمه الله goes into العام. العام تعريفه، العام لغة الشامل، واصطلاحا اللفظ المستغرق لجميع أفراده بلا حصر، مثل إن الأبرار لفي نعيم. فخرج بقولنا المستغرق لجميع أفراده ما لا يتناول إلا واحدا كالعلم والنكرة في سياق الإثبات، كقوله تعالى فتحرير رقبة، لأنها لا تتناول جميع الأفراد على وجه الشمول، وإنما تتناول واحدا غير معين. وخرج بقولنا بلا حصر ما يتناول جميع أفراده مع الحصر كأسماء العدد 100 و1000 ونحوهما.
The general, العام. The definition, العام, linguistically means inclusive, and technically it means an all-compassing word that includes all its individual elements without restriction, such as the righteous are in bliss. So what is excluded from our words includes all its individual elements. It's whatever includes only a single element, such as a specific noun or an indefinite article in the context of an affirmation, such as the saying of the Most High, the freeing of a neck. This is because it does not address all the elements by way of inclusiveness, but deals with one which is unspecified. And what is not included by the words without restriction is whatever addresses all its elements with restriction, such as the number nouns, 100,000 and the like.
The author, rahimahullah, he goes into al-amu. Al-am is general. This chapter, al-am, is from the important chapters of ilm al-usul. It's one of the most important chapters of ilm al-usul. Because our religion, our sharia, it is general in all situations, all places, all individuals. Our religion is general. It is general in all people. It is general to all places. It is general to all situations. So the topic of general, am, is a necessary topic. It's a necessary chapter that a person needs to understand and needs to digest. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he defined the word al-ammu lughatan in the English language, in the Arabic language. The Shaykh, he defined al-ammu lughatan in the Arabic language. And the word al-ammu lughatan in the Arabic language, it means ash-shamilu. Ash-shamilu means inclusive. It means inclusive. That's what it means in the Arabic language. Then the Shaykh rahimahullah, he defined it according to the istilah al-usuliyina, the definition of the scholars of usul al-fiqh. And the scholars of usul al-fiqh, they have many definitions of al-am, general. Many. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he had chose bita'rifin jayyidin, a good definition. He chose the best of those definitions. And the definition is al-lafzu al-mustaghriqu li jami'i afradihi bila hasrin. Now we're going to go through each point by point, the definition. The Shaykh said al-lafzu. Al-lafzu means a word. So what falls under there? What falls under there is six things. Five things. The first one is al-ammu. When you say al-lafzu, the am falls under there, the general. The second thing that falls under it is al-khasu, the specific. The third that falls under it is the unrestricted al-mutlaq. And the fourth that falls under it is asma'ul adad, countable nouns. And last but not least is al-mushtarak, a synonym noun. A noun that the word has many usages. One word has many usages. Those are the five that fall under al-lafzu. Umum, it only deals with words. Am cannot be an action. ولذلك الأصولين they say العموم من عوارض الألفاظ. The scholars they say that the umum is from the characteristics of words. It's an attribute of the word. Actions cannot be taken as general. For example, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he prayed two rak'ah in the middle of the Kaaba, inside the Kaaba. Inside the black box, the Prophet went in there and he prayed inside it. Salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi. Does this mean that a person is allowed to pray inside the Kaaba, whether it's a voluntary prayer or it's an obligatory prayer? Should we take it general? Or should we specify it to the voluntary prayer that the Prophet did it for? We'll say it's only specific to the voluntary prayer, because the action does not show generalization. You can't generalize it and say this salah can be prayed for. It can be prayed with the voluntary or the obligatory salah. Because the action of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not show obligation. It doesn't show generalization. It doesn't show general. Even that the Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen in Sharh al-Mumti', he mentioned that it encompasses the voluntary and the obligatory. But where did he take that from, that generalization? He didn't take it from the Prophet's action. He knows that the general cannot be taken from the Prophet's action. He took it from whatever is for the voluntary, generally speaking, is for the obligatory as well. And whatever is for the obligatory is for the general when it comes to salah. Unless there comes a delil and specifies it for the voluntary over the obligatory, or the obligatory over the voluntary. So the Sheikh is using that. That's where his argument is. His teacher as well, Abdurrahman Nasir al-Sa'di, they are of the opinion that you can pray inside the Kaaba, whether it's an obligatory prayer or a voluntary prayer. But I want you to understand, they're not taking this from the Prophet's action. They're taking it from another angle, which is the voluntary prayer and the obligatory prayer generally, or let me not use that word, the obligatory prayer and the voluntary prayer, both of them are the same. They're both the same. There's no specification for one over the other, unless there comes a delil that specifies one over the other. That's a side point. Come back to the point I was trying to mention, which is al-lafzu. The am is a lafz, it's a word. It's a what? A word. So al-umum min awarid al-anfad. Generalization, where is it taken from? When can you say this is general ruling? From the Prophet's speech, alayhi salatu wasalam, not his actions. That's the first point. The second thing is al-mustaghriqu li jami'i afradihi, an all-encompassing, which includes all its individual elements. What does that mean? And what does it? What do we get rid of by al-mustaghriqu li jami'i afradi? What does it mean, al-mustaghriqu li jami'i afradi? It's all-encompassing, which includes all of its elements. All of its elements can fall under it. Two things are out of that point. We're getting rid of two things. So the am, when you say it, all of those things fall under it. There's no exception. Two things, يَحْتَرِزُ بِهِ عَنْ أَمْرَيْنِ. Two things are out of that point. What is it? Al-khasu, the specific. The Shaykh mentioned it here for you. Like al-alam. Al-alam is a noun, right? Or it's a name. اسم يعين المسمى مطلقا علمه كجعفر وخرنقا. Alam is a name. A name It's not المستغرق لجميع أفراده. When you say Zayd, for example, you're only talking about one person. You specified it. And the second thing that leaves this point is, or that we get rid of it in this point, is the al-mutlaq. So slowly pay attention here. When we said al-lafadhu, how many things were in there? Five. What happened now? The next point, when we said al-mustaghriqu li jami'i afradihi, we got rid of how many? Two of those five, which is al-khasu and al-mutlaq. Al-khasu we understand because it's specific. We understand that it's going to leave that. But what about mutlaq? Isn't mutlaq general? The mutlaq, the ulama, they say, its umum is not shumuli, it's umum badali. Okay, what does that mean? Okay, pay attention here. The mutlaq is general as well. The mutlaq is also general, it's unrestricted. But they said its generalization is umumun badaliyun. What does it mean, umum badali? For example, if you say أكرم الطلاب, honor the students, and let's say there are 20 students in front of you. You said أكرم الطلاب, honor the students. When can you claim that you have followed this command? Is when you honor all 20 of them. If you honor 19 of them, I will together. أكرم الطلاب, الطلاب, أكرم الطلاب, الطلاب, honor the students. And there are 20 students in front of you. And I said, honor the students. When can you say to me, I've honored the students? Is it when you honor the 19 students or when you honor all of those students? It's when you honor all of them. Akrim al-tullaba, honor the students. That's rumumun shumuliyun, meaning all of them fall under it. The honoring here encompasses all of them. المستغرق لجميع أفرادي. All of them are they not students? They all fall under it. لكن مطلق is عموم بدلي. It's عموم بدلي. How is it? أكرم طالبا on a student. It's general from one angle because I haven't restricted which student is. It can be Zayd, it can be Bakr, it can be Amr. I said on a student. But the minute you honor a student and you go and you stand up and you say, Bakr, I honor you. Instead of Amr. That's what's called Badali. Instead of Amr. He's taking the place of Amr. It could be any of them. The minute that you honor one, you've restricted it now. The minute you honor it, it does. So, al-mustaghriq li-jami'i afradi is not in there. But from an angle, it's am, because I didn't mention who you should honor. Whereas the am, all of them are going to be honored. Does that make sense? That makes sense, I hope. The last point of the definition is bila hasrin. So we said al-lafzu, it's a word. Okay? Al-mustaghriq li jami'i afradi, which encompasses and it includes all its individual elements. Bila hasrin, without restriction. Bila hasri means without restriction. Without restriction, what leaves now? Asma'ul adad and al-mushtarak. They leave it now. Asma'ul adad like mi'ah wa alfin wa mi'at alf, like 1,000, 1,000, 100,000. This is asma'ul adad. That's restriction. And al-mushtarak. Mushtarak is a what? Like for example, the word ayn. Ayn can be used for an eye, it can be used for gold, and it can also be used for the spring, and it can also be used for a thief, all of those. It can also be used for a spy, all of those ayn. It's a lafz which is mushtarak. The Sheikh then gave an example for the am. He gave an example for the am that shows what am is. He said, إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ. The word innal al-abrara. Al-abrara are what? The righteous. Lafi na'imin, they are in bliss. So al-abrara here is lafzun mustaghriqun li jami'i afradi bila hasri. It's all the pious people. Because in there is the alif al-istighraqiyah, which we're going to see soon, inshallah, when we speak about سياغ العموم. When we speak about the forms of general. Then the author رحمه الله he says سياغ العموم. سياغ العموم سبع. الأول ما دل على العموم بمادته مثل كل وجميع وكافة وقاطبة وعامة كقوله تعالى إنا كل شيء خلقناه بقدر أسماء الشرط. الثاني أسماء الشرط كقوله تعالى من عمل صالحا فلنفسه فأينما تولوا فثم وجه الله. الثالث أسماء الاستفهام كقوله تعالى فمن يأتيكم بماء معين ماذا أجبتم المرسلين فأين تذهبون. الأسماء الرابعة الأسماء الموصولة كقوله تعالى والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به أولئك هم المتقون والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. الخامسة النكرة في سياق النفي أو النهي أو الشرط أو الاستفهام الإنكاري كقوله تعالى وما من إله إلا الله واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا إن تبدوا شيئا أو تخفوه فإن الله كان بكل شيء عليما. من إله غير الله يأتيكم بضياء. السادس المعرف بالإضافة مفردا كان أم مجموعا كقوله تعالى واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم فاذكروا آلاء الله لعلكم تفلحون. السابعة المعرف بأل الاستغراقية المعرف بأل الاستغراقية مفردا كان أم مجموعة كقوله تعالى وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا وإذا بلغ الأطفال منكم الحلم فليستأذنوا كما استأذن الذين من قبلكم وإذا بلغ الأطفال منكم الحلم فليستأذنوا كما استأذن الذين من قبلهم. وأما المعرف بالعهدية فإنه بحسب المعهود فإن كان عاما فالمعرف عام وإن كان خاصا فالمعرف خاص. مثال العام قوله تعالى إذ قال ربك للملائكة إني خالق بشرا من طين فإذا سويته ونفخت فيه من روحي فقعوا له ساجدين فإذا سويته ونفخت فيه من روحي فقعوا له ساجدين فسجد الملائكة كلهم أجمعون. ومثال الخاص قوله تعالى كما أرسلنا إلى فرعون رسولا فعصى فرعون الرسول. وأما المعرف بأل التي لبيان الجنس فلا يعم الأفراد. وأما المعرف بأل التي لبيان الجنس فلا يعم الأفراد. فإذا قلت الرجل خير من المرأة أو الرجال خير من النساء فليس المراد أن كل فرد من الرجال خير من كل فرد من النساء وإنما المراد أن هذا الجنس خير من هذا الجنس وإن كان قد يوجد من أفراد النساء من هو خير من بعض الرجال.
Forms of general العام. The seven types of wording which indicate generality are number one, what shows generality in itself, such as kullu, every, jami', entirely, kafah, totality, qatibah, all without exception, and al-'am, general, such as the saying of the Most High, indeed everything we have created with due proportion and measure. Number two, nouns of condition, like the saying of the Most High, whoever does a righteous deed, then it is for himself. Wherever you turn, there is the face of Allah. 3. Interrogative nouns, like the saying of the Most High, Who is it that will bring forth gushing water? What did you answer the messengers? Where are you going? Number four, relative nouns, like the saying of the Most High, and the one who has brought the truth, and they who believed in it, those are the righteous. And those who strive for us, we will surely guide them to our ways. Indeed, and that is a warning for whoever would fear Allah. And to Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth. Number five, the indefinite noun in the context of negation, prohibition, or rhetorical question. Like the saying of the Most High, there is no true God but Allah. And worship Allah and join none with Him. If you reveal anything or conceal it, indeed Allah is the knower of everything. Which deity is there other than Allah that can bring light for you? Do you then not hear? Number six, the possession noun, singular or plural, defined through al-idafa, a possessive noun, like the saying of the Most High, mention the grace of Allah upon you. Number seven, the defined noun, singular or plural, by the way of definite article al of inclusiveness, like the saying of the Most High, and man was created weak. And when the children among you come of age, let also ask permission of those before them. As for the defined noun by virtue of the al acknowledgement, then it is according to what has been acknowledged. So if it is general, then it is deemed as defined in general terms. On the other hand, if it is specific, then it is considered defined as specific. An example of al-'am is the saying of the Most High, the Lord said to the angels, I create man from clay. When I have breathed into him of my spirit and fashioned him, they prostrated to him. All the angels, every last one of them, fell down in prostration. An example of specific is the saying of the Most High, as you sent a messenger to Fir'aun, so Fir'aun disobeyed the messenger, so we took hold of him in a severe way. As for the al that helps to define the class noun, and then the singular nouns are not made general. If you were to say, the man is better than the woman, or the men are better than the women, it is not intended that each and every member of the male gender is better than each and every individual of the female gender. Rather, that the male gender is better than the female gender, though there may be members of the female gender that are better than some of their counterparts.
The Shaykh Rahimahullah, he now goes into Siyaghul Umum, the form of general. These are alfaz, words that indicate and show general statements of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, or general statements of Allah Azza wa Jalla. ولذلك, a person can't say هذه الآية عامة, that this term is this ayah is general, or no one can say that this hadith is general unless he knows siyaghul umum, the forms of general. The Shaykh here, he mentioned seven of them. The Shaykh mentioned seven. There are many more than that. There are much more than that. Like the Shaykh mentioned seven, which are the most common seven. It's the most common ones. We will go through one after the other, inshallah ta'ala. The first one that the Shaykh mentioned is مَا دَلَّ عَلَى الْعُمُومِ بِمَادَّتِهِ, what shows generality in itself, in and within itself. And the Shaykh mentioned the word كُل وَجَمِيعُ وَكَافَ وَقَاطِبَ وَعَامَّ, and he gave the example of the ayah إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. The word كُل, it shows generality in and within itself. Same with the word jami', same with the word kafa, same with the word qatiba, same with this word amma. They all show generalization and generality in and within itself. And the Shaykh brought the ayah, inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu, everything Allah says, we created it bi qadarin, with a qadar. Inna Allah bi kulli shay'in alim, Allah has knowledge over everything. Another hadith which would be evidence is isna'u du kulla shay'in, everything to your wives illa nikah, except sexual intercourse when they are on their menstruation. Do everything with your wife when she's on her menstruation except sexual intercourse. So you're allowed to do anything with your wife other than sexual intercourse because she's on her menses. The word kul, the scholars, they said, hiya aqwa siyagul umumi. It is the strongest form of generalization. Like they said, it has to be in the context of affirmation. It has to be in the context of an affirmation. But if it's in a context where a negation goes before it, then it doesn't show generalization. It doesn't show generalization. It doesn't. For example, if you say, لم يقم, they did not stand, كل الطلاب, all the students. The word كل doesn't show generalization here. It doesn't. It doesn't. Because a negation went before it. Because some of them could have stood up. Okay? And the scholars, they call this سلب العموم. When the generalization is deliberately stripped from it. Also the word جميع. Sheikh mentioned that as well, as the first part. جميع. Allah says in the ayah, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. I am a messenger to all of you. You know, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ نَحْنُ جَمِيعٌ مُنْتَصِرٌ. So the word جميع means all of us. Okay? The word كافة as well, where Allah said, وَقَاتِلُوا الْمُشْرِكِينَ, fight with the disbelievers, كافة, all of them. كَمَا يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ كافة, as they are all fighting with you. Another word that the Sheikh didn't mention, which is معشر, معاشر. They also show generalization as well. Like when Allah said, يَا مَعْشَرَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. Generalization. So it falls under مَا دَلَّ عَلَى الْعُمُومِ بِمَادَتِهِ. What shows generality in and within itself. The second one is, that the Sheikh mentioned, is nouns of condition. Nouns of condition. أَسْمَاءُ الشَّرْط. Like Allah تبارك وتعالى, when He said, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِي. Whoever does righteous action, he done it for himself. You see, also another example could be, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَوَ حَسْبُهُ. Anyone who relies on Allah تبارك وتعالى and comes with tawakkul, فَوَ حَسْبُهُ, Allah is enough for them. And also another example could be, مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ. Because the man here is asma' shart. So four places that I mentioned. All four of those places is a ismu shartin yufidu al-umum. It shows generalization. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِي وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فَعَلَيْهَا. Those two. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Number three. مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ. Four. Also, one of the asma' al-shart is the term أَيْنَ. As Allah said, فَأَيْنَ مَا تُوَلُّوا فَتَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Wherever you turn, Allah's face is there. فَأَيْنَ. The word أَيْنَ is ismu shartin yadullu ala al-umum. It's a noun of condition and it shows generalization. أَيْنَ is. The ma again is مُؤَكِّدَة. It's an emphasis only. The same is the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, أَيَّ مَمْرَأَة. Whichever woman, نَكَحَت, gets married, and marries off, نفسها, she married herself off, بغير إذن وليها, without the permission of her guardian, فنكاحها باطل, فنكاحها باطل, فنكاحها باطل. The messenger said it three times, فنكاحها باطل, فنكاحها باطل, فنكاحها باطل. But look what the hadith says. It says, أيما. Okay, again, أين, أيما is also, which word are we looking at here? We're not looking at the ma, we're just looking at the word ay. Ay is a what? It's a ism shart yadullu ala al-umum, and the ma is mu'akkada. It's a mu'akkada lahu. It's emphasizing on it. Also from the huruf al-sharti are the in and idha. In and idha. Lakin the in and the idha, they don't show generalization and they don't show specification. Even that though, they are asma'u sharti. Which ones? In and idha. The ones that show, I mentioned it to you, are three. Man shows generalization. Ayna shows generalization. And ay shows generalization. The other two, which is in and idha, they don't show generalization. The third one that the Sheikh mentioned is asma'u istifham. Interrogative noun, which is فَمَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِمَاءٍ مَعِينٍ. Who's going to bring you gushing water, pure good water? Who's going to bring it for you? It's a question here. فَمَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ The word man here is ism istifham. Generalize. Who? Also, the other one is the word ma. Ma. Allah says, مَاذَا أَجَبْتُمُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ Ma is ism istifham. It encompasses everything. Also, أَيْنَ The word أَيْنَ is also ism istifham, sorry. When you say فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ Where are you going? So we took the word أَيْنَ can become أسماء شرط and it can also be what? Ism istifham, right? Good. Also, there is another thing that are istifham. They are interrogative nouns, but they don't show generalization. What is it? هَل هَل, even that though it is an istifham, interrogative noun, and the hamza. The hamza, both of them, even that though they are interrogative nouns, ليست من سياغ العموم. It doesn't show generalization. For example, if somebody says هل جاء زيد, did زيد come? We say هل is a harf istifham, right? لكن لا يدل على العموم. It doesn't show generalization. The fourth one that the Sheikh mentioned is الأسماء الموصولة. الأسماء الموصولة that the Sheikh mentioned, which is the relative noun, right? The relative noun. The relative noun, which is والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به أولئك هم المفلحون. والذي, the word الذي here. الذي here is from the أسماء الموصولة, the relative noun, right? How do we know it shows generalization? Because look at the ayah, what did it say? أولئك was used. هم was also used. So it says generalization, right? Another example is والذين. والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا. الذين is ism موصول. It encompasses all of the مجاهد. إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى. The word من is ism موصول as well. It encompasses every single person who fears Allah Azza wa Jalla. Also, ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. The word ما is ism موصول as well. In two places in that verse, ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. It also shows generalization. Also, فانكحوا ما طاب لكم من النساء. The word فانكحوا ما طاب. The ما here is also ism موصول. It's a relative noun. What does it encompass? All of the righteous women of Bani Adam. بنات آدم, the daughters of Adam, you can marry them. The fifth type that the Shaykh rahimahullah mentioned is النكرة في سياق النفي, the indefinite, which is in the form of a negation, I mean in the context of a negation. This one, the example that the Shaykh rahimahullah brought is وما من إله إلا الله. لكن listen to this, the word the النكرة في سياق النفي, pay attention to this. It can show generalization in one of two situations. Pay attention. النكرة, the indefinite, which is in the context of the indefinite, which is in the context of a negation, it shows generalization. But the way that it shows generalization is in two ways. Either نصاً في العموم, it's a نص in عموم, or it's ظاهر في العموم. What does that mean? نص في العموم means أنها لا تحتمل غير العموم. It cannot take except the generalization. There's nothing else you can say. There's no other interpretation except. It only shows generalization. And that's when the word من enters it. And the example the Sheikh brought here is وما, the ما here is a negation, right? إلهنا is the what? Is the indefinite. So the negation we found, the indefinite is ilah, and the word min is in there. If the word min is in there as well, now it becomes nasun fil umum. It's a nas, meaning it's only general. It cannot be any other meaning. Are we all together? Or the nakiratu fi siyaqi nafi, it can show the generalization in what way? Zahirun fil umum. Zahirun fil umum means what? 80%. 10%, 90%, sorry, 80%, 70%, 60%. It shows that it's general. such as ذلك الكتاب, that book, لا ريب فيه, there's no doubt in it, فيه in it, هدى للمتقين, it's a guidance for the believers. The word ريب here is a نكرة في سياق النفي, right? It's an indefinite in the context of a negation. Where's the negation? لا ريب, the لا is already there. The scholars, they say, تدل على نفي جميع الريب, it negates all of doubts from the Quran al-Azim. But they said, وهي ظاهرة في العموم. But it's ظاهر. It's ظاهر. Because من didn't enter it. من did not enter it. Also the Sheikh brought here, while he was on that point, he mentioned in there as well, is the النكرة في سياق النهي, and the نكرة في سياق الشرط, and the نكرة في سياق الاستفهام الإنكاري. So what does it mean? We already know what, and the nakira, the indefinite in the context of a negation. We already took that. What did he mean by the indefinite, which is in the context of a prohibition? Like, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَاشِبْ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا, and do not associate partners with him. وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. شَيْئًا is a nakira. It's in the context of a negation, because it says وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا, and do not associate partners, prohibited. So it shows generalization. That's the example for the, what do you call it? النكرة في سياق النهي. What about النكرة في سياق الشرطي? The indefinite, which is in the context of a condition. Like, إن تبدو شيئاً, if you hide something, if you show something, أو تخفوه, or you hide it, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا, Allah is one who has knowledge of everything. The word here, إِن تُبُدُوا شَيْئًا, it's a what? An indefinite. In the context of a condition, because the word in is there, right? What does it do? فَتَعُمُّ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ, everything, it's generalization. Okay? Another example for that is, إِن تَجْتَرِبُوا كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَنُدْخِلْكُمْ مُدْخَلًا كَرِيمًا. Ama the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, where he said, "Man awa dalatan," anyone who finds a lost property, finds something that's lost. فَوَ ضَالٌ مَا لَمْ يُعَرِّفْهَا, he is astray if he doesn't advertise it. If a person finds something which is lost, and he doesn't go out there and advertise it, and he doesn't announce it and tell the people and describe it, then he himself is misguided. The word ضالة is a نكرة في سياق الشرطي. So it shows generalization. So any property you find, even if it's small, even if it's big, it doesn't matter. The third one that the Sheikh mentioned was, after the نفي, was الاستفهام الإنكاري, which is called the rhetorical question, right? Rhetorical question. An example for that is مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِالضِّيَاءِ. So we have the word مَنْ إِلَهٌ. إِلَهٌ here is a what? It's a نكرة. مَنْ is before it, which is a استفهام, إنكاري, shows generalization. بِالضِّيَاءٍ is also a نكرة. ضِيَاءٍ is also a نكرة, is an indefinite. In the context of a what? Of a rhetorical question, الاستفهام الإنكاري. So it shows generalization. Another example is من هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم من السماء والأرض. Is there anyone who's going to create, is there any creation, sorry, other than Allah that provides from you from the سماء and the أرض? خالق here is a نكرة. In the context of a what? It's an indefinite in the context of a rhetorical question, so it shows generalization. As for like in the verse in Surah Al-Insan where Allah says هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا, and the ayah, هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Those two verses, it's an استفهام إنكاري. And the word حِينٌ is an indefinite, right? And هَلْ is already mentioned, which is استفهام إنكاري. Shouldn't it not show generalization? It doesn't. هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ. تِجَارَةٍ here is what? It's an indefinite, it's a nakira. In the context of a what? استفهام إنكاري, which is هل. It doesn't show generalization. Why? Because they said this is not استفهام إنكاري. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. This is called استفهام تقريري. استفهام تقريري. And the second one, which is هل أدلكم على تجارة تنجيكم من عذاب أليمنا. It's called استفهام تشويقي. تشويقي. So it's not استفهام إنكاري. That's why it doesn't show generalization. What about if an indefinite comes in the context of an affirmation? Does it show generalization? No, it doesn't show generalization. Like, وَلْيَكْتُبْ بَيْنَكُمْ كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْلِ. وَلْيَكْتُبْ, write between yourselves. كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْلِ. The word كَاتِبْ here is what? كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْلِ. كَاتِبٌ is indefinite. It's in the context of an affirmation, right? In the context of a statement, an affirmation. It doesn't show generalization. The scholars, they said, it only shows a generalization if it's في سياق الامتنان. If the nakira في سياق الإثبات comes in a what? In the context of امتنان. Allah is saying, I favored you. Like what he said, وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً طَهُورًا. I sent down on you from the sky water, a pure water. Allah is trying to tell us his favor that he bestowed upon us. So this shows generalization. مَاءً here shows generalization. Same here is فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانٌ. فَاكِهَةٌ is an indefinite. You see, نَخْلٌ is an indefinite. رُمَّان is an indefinite. يَخْرُجُ مِن بُطُونِهِمَا شَرَابٌ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُ فِيهِ شِفَاءٌ لِلنَّاسِ. شِفَاءٌ is an indefinite. All of them are فِي سِيَاقِ الْإِمْتِنَانِ. In the context of a what? إمتنان. Allah is mentioning his favors upon us. And the favors, of course, is إثبات. It is an إثبات. It's an affirmation, but it's a type of an affirmation, which is إمتنان. Allah is saying, I favored you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number six, the Shaykh mentioned, المعرف بالإضافة مفردا كان أم مجموعا. Number six is the possession, noun, singular or plural. An example that the Shaykh brought is, وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. وَذْكُرُوا mention, نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ, the blessing of Allah, عَلَيْكُمْ upon you. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. The word ni'mah is a what? It's one blessing, right? Okay, is a what? It's, remember we're looking for what? نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. It has to be مُضَافًا مُضَافٌ إِلَيْهِ. Are we all together? So here, the mu'arraf comes in many ways, right? It comes in alif and lam, right? And it also comes in idafa. It comes in al-idafa, right? Ah, you need to know that. Ni'mat Allahi, you've made it mu'arraf. It's now known. The blessing of Allah. Like in the word ni'mah is a what? It's mufrad. It shows generalization. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثِ. It also shows generalization, which is بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ. Describing the blessing to Allah. The word ni'mah is one, but it shows generalization. In another ayah, Allah says, أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ صِيَامٍ رَفَثُ إِلَى نِسَائِكُمْ. Okay? Here, أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ, I have made permissible for you what? لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ. لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ. لَيْلَة here is a what? It's a, it's, it shows generalization. It shows generalization. Also, if it comes in plural as well, the idafa, if it becomes plural as well, فَذْكُرُوا آلَاء اللَّهِ. The word ni'mah, what's the plural for it? آلَاء اللَّهِ, right? آلَاء is the plural of the word ni'mah. If somebody asks you, ni'mah is plural, is ni'am, and it's also آلَاء. So فَذْكُرُوا, remember, آلَاء اللَّهِ, it shows generalization. The آلَاء is being ascribed to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So that's why the author, look what he said. What did he say? What did the Shaykh say? إذا المعرف بالإضافة مفردا كان أم مجموعا. And he gave you the مفرد, which is وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And the مجموع, he gave you the ayah, فَذْكُرُوا آلَاءَ اللَّهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Okay, they show generalization. Remember all of the blessings of Allah. It's not a specific blessing. Okay. Another example could be for that one, which is إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ يَنْهَيَانِكُمْ عَنْ لُحُومُ الْحُمُورِ الْأَهْلِيَّةِ فَإِنَّهَا رِجْسٌ. Allah and His Messenger are prohibiting you from لُحُومُ الْحُمُورِ الْأَهْلِيَّةِ فَإِنَّهَا رِجْسٌ. Again, لُحُوم here is a what? It's al-jam'u al-mudaf. Shows generalization. What does it show? It shows generalization. The seventh and last one that the Shaykh brought here is al-mu'arraf bil-al. We took al-mu'arraf bil-idafa and al-mu'arraf bil-al. That which is definite through possession, we took that already. And now we're taking the mu'arraf, which is definite, through the article al, the. Okay? Now, I'm going to quickly summarize this one for you because it's very important. The al, in terms of it showing generalization or not, is three types. It's how many types? Three types. The first one is ما يدل على العموم, that which shows generalization. Shows generalization. And that's the al al-istighraqiyya. They call it al al-istighraqiyya. The al which is al-istighraqiyya. That one shows generalization. And the Shaykh here brought the ayah, أَوِ الطِّفْلِ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يَظْهَرُوا عَلَى عَوْرَاتِ النِّسَاءِ. Okay? The one that people know most is إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Al-insan. The al-inna is called al-istighraqiyya. Shows generalization. The question here is, what's the dhabit? How do I know the al-istighraqiyya? The scholars, they say the way that you know it is, if you put the word kul in there, the meaning will change. If you replace the al with kul, it will stand, the meaning will still stand. That's what Ibn Hisham mentions in his Mughni al-Labib. Okay? The second type is مَا يَدُلُّ عَلَى الْعُمُومِ فِي حَالٍ دُونَ حَالٍ, that which shows generalization in one situation and not another situation. So some situations it can show generalization, and in some situations it doesn't show generalization. That's the one that is called al-ahdiyah. Al-ahdiyah. Second type. The first one, it shows generalization all the time. Which one is it? Al-istighraqiyah. It always shows generalization. How do you know the al-istighraqiyah? And what's the dhabit for it? How can you determine it? How do you know al-istighraqiyah from the other ones? You know it by placing the word kul in there and the meaning won't change. The second one is al-ahdiyah. Al-ahdiyah, it can show generalization and it may not show generalization. Depends. Okay. If the thing that's been spoken about, remember al-ahdiyah, it comes in three types. Let me explain this to you first. Al-ahdiyah, it comes in three types. The first one, they call it ahdi, they call it ahd dhikri. They call it ahd dhikri. Ahd dhikri. Which means, if someone says, اشتريت كتابا, I bought a book. ثم قرأت, then I read الكتاب, the book. You already know what book he's talking about, because he just told you, I bought a book and I read the book. It's been mentioned for you there and then. That's what the first type is called. It's called ahd dhikri, meaning it was just mentioned. The second one is called ahd dhihni. Ahd dhihni means someone came and they spoke to you about, for example, the importance of Kitab Fathul Bari. Someone talked to you about Fathul Bari and they told you the value and the benefits in Fathul Bari, which they said is the best sharh of Sahih al-Bukhari. And the next day you came and you told the person, اشتريت الكتاب, I bought the book. A day later. This is called عهد ذهني. It's in the people's minds. It wasn't mentioned, it was not in a context, but it's in the mind of the people. The third one is, it's called عهد حضوري. عهد حضوري is when you say, اشتريت, I bought هذا الكتاب, this book. This book, and you point at it. The al in all of those three are all called ahd, but they're different types of ahd. Okay, that's a side benefit. You can find that more details in Mughni al-Labib by Ibn Hisham al-Ansari. Okay, here now. In terms of the al-ahdiyya, showing generalization or not, it's two ways. Okay, we're not going to go into its types, and okay, we've done that already. We want to go into al-ahdiyya, whether how it shows generalization or not. I said it can show generalization and it may not show generalization. I said that right? When does it show generalization? The thing that was being addressed here, because remember all those three examples I gave you, the all three types, it's something that's there, It's something that we both know, one way or another, right? That's adiya. If the thing that's being addressed, and that you and I both know what it is, if it's general, then the alif alam that's in it makes it general. فَيَكُونُ الْمُعَرَّفُ عَامًا. So the ma'hud, the thing in the mind of ours, is general. So then it becomes general with the alif alam entering it. The example for that is, إِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ, when your Lord said, لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ, to the angels, إِنِّي خَالِقٌ, I'm going to create, بَشَرًا human, مِنْ طِينٍ, from clay. فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُ, when I straighten it, وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِ, and I blow my soul into it, فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ, all of you drop in prostration. فَسَجِدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, the angels, they prostrated. كُلُّهُمْ, all of them, أَجْمَعُونَ, all of them. The word malaika was mentioned before, which is, إِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَ. Malaika was the one that was mentioned in the beginning. It's called ahdiya, right? It was already spoken about. And it's, which type of ahdiya is it? Ahdikri, right? Ha, that's the type it is right now here. The angels are already general. They're a big creation, they're general. It doesn't mention which angel frustrated, it just says the angels. Then Allah says, فَإِذَا وَسَوَيْتُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي, فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, the angels prostrated. The al, which is in the second al-malaika, is generalization. Why? Because the previous angels that were spoken about was general in the first place. Okay? The second one is, it's not general, it's specific. That which you and I are talking about is specific. Okay? And then the alif al-lam was put into it. It becomes what? Specific, it can't be general. Like the Shaykh brought example, which is, كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ رَسُولًا, we sent Fir'aun a messenger. You and I both know the messenger that was sent to Fir'aun. It's not all messengers. It's a specific messenger that was sent. Who is it? Nabilahi Musa. We already know that. فَعَصَى فِرْعَوْنُ الرَّسُولًا, Fir'aun disobeyed الرَّسُولًا. Here is going to be what? It's going to be specific. Are we all together? Some scholars, they don't take that opinion. And they actually took a benefit out of this. They said that Fir'aun disobeyed Nabilahi Musa. And the second type of Ar-Rasulah here, even though there is Ahdiya, are we all together? They say that the Ma'hud is also Am. How is it Am? If one messenger is disobeyed, it's like you disobeyed the what? The entire messengers. Like in according to this now, we need to take that way and the way it is. And the Shaykh brought another, the third type of al, which is that which does not show generalization at all. Okay. So what was the first one? It shows generalization always. And that's al-istighraqiyya, right? And there's the second one, which is it can show generalization depending, and it may not show depending. And that's the which one? Al-ahdiyya. The third one is the one that doesn't show generalization. It doesn't. Which is the one, it's called and it's referred to Al-allati li-bayani al-jins. Al-allati li-bayani al-jins. And that's the one that the Shaykh rahimahullah brought for saying Al-rajlu khayru min al-mar'ah, a man is better than a woman. He is not talking about all men. It's talking about jinsul rajul. That's what it's called. Allati li bayanil jins. It's jinsiyya. It's talking about the gender of men. But it's not talking about every single man is better than every single woman. Because there are women that are better than men. Okay? That's what the Shaykh rahimahullah was speaking about there, inshaAllah ta'ala. The author then says, الْعَمَلُ بِالْعَامِ يَجِبُ الْعَمَلُ بِعُمُومِ اللَّفْظِ الْعَامِ حَتَّى تَثْبُتَ تَخْصِيصُهُ لِأَنَّ الْعَمَلَ بِنُصُوصِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ وَاجِبٌ عَلَى مَا تَقْتَضِيهِ دَلَالَتُهَا حَتَّى يَقُومَ دَلِيلٌ عَلَى خِلَافِ ذَلِكَ.
Acting on the general. It is necessary that we act on the general until it is proven that it is specific. This is because the text of the Quran and the Sunnah require we act on what they signify until evidence to the contrary until evidence to the contrary becomes apparent.
Two things we take from the statement of the Shaykh here, which is that the general is obligatory for us to act upon it as soon as it reaches us. As soon as we hear of this general text, we need to implement it straight away. And we don't say, oh, I'm not going to follow the general text unless I find a specific, because there could possibly be a specific No, you act upon the general and you don't stand around and wait for a specific evidence to come about. The second point that we benefit from the statement of the Shaykh here is that the general is implemented even after the specific occurs. Just not in that specific thing, just not in that text where it was specified. But anything other than that, we implement it. So if a general comes and it specifies something, the specific, okay, it's an exception here. We don't implement it in that specific. But then we will still implement it in other things. That's also what we benefit from the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala. The author then says, وَإِذَا وَرَدَ الْعَامُ عَلَى سَبَبٍ خَاسٍ وَجَبَ الْعَمَلُ بِعُمُومِهِ لِأَنَّ الْعِبْرَةَ بِعُمُومِ اللَّفْظِ لَا بِخُصُوصِ السَّبَبِ إِلَّا أَنْ يَدُلَّ دَلِيلٌ عَلَى تَخْصِيصِهِ الْعَامِ بِمَا يُشْبِهُ حَالَ السَّبَبِ الَّذِي وَرَدَ مِنْ أَجْلِهِ فَيَخْتَصُّ بِمَا يُشَابِهُهَا مثال ما لا دليل على تخصيص آيات الظهار فإن سبب نزولها ظهار أوس بن صامت والحكم عام فيه وفي غيره ومثال ما دل الدليل على تخصيصه قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس من البر الصيام في السفر فإن سببه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في سفر فرأى زحاما ورجلا قد ظلل عليه فقال ما هذا قالوا صائم فقال ليس من البر الصيام في السفر فهذا العموم خاص بما يشبه حال هذا الرجل وهو ما يشق عليه الصيام في السفر والدليل على تخصيصه بذلك أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يصوم في السفر حيث كان لا يشق عليه ولا يفعل صلى الله عليه وسلم ما ليس ببر.
So when we find something general that has come about due to a special reason, then we must act upon the general text, because what counts is the generality of the wording and not the specifics of the reason that text was revealed. Except when an evidence indicates the specific nature of that text, thereby making it specific to whatever is similar to it. And an example of when no evidence makes a general text specific is the saying of the Most High regarding Dhihar, when a man pronounces that his wife is at the back of his mother to him, intending by it to divorce her. The reason of revelation was the companion Aws ibn Samit, who said this to his wife, but the ruling is general for him and other than him. And an example of when evidence makes something specific is the saying of the Prophet ﷺ, it is not from righteousness to fast while traveling. The reason behind that was when the Prophet ﷺ was on a journey, whereupon he saw a crowd and a man being shaded by them and said, what is this? They said, he is fasting. He said, it is not from righteousness to fast while traveling. This generality is specific to those who resemble the condition of that man. In other words, when fasting becomes strenuous for someone whilst traveling, the proof indicating it is specific is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast while on a journey when it was not difficult for him, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not do that which was not righteous.
The Shaykh rahimahullah here, he goes into a mas'ala, a very famous mas'ala known as, if there comes a general text, the text is general, but it came down on a specific person. So the wording of the text is general, but it came down on a specific individual. Should we implement the wording, or should we specify it to that person it came down on? The Shaykh rahimahullah is of the opinion that we follow the wording, the generalization of the wording. And he brought two evidence for that. Even that though it came down on a particular person, the Shaykh said, we go by the generality of the word. An example he gave is the Surah Al-Mujadala. You can say Mujadala or Mujadila. Both ways you can say it. It's the issue of Al-Dhihar, where Allah says, الَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْكُمْ مِنْ نِسَائِهِمْ مَا هُنَّ أُمَّهَاتِهِمْ. The word that was used in the ayah is general. How is it general? Allah says, الَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ. الَّذِينَ, what did we just take? It's ism mawsoola, right? A relative noun. What does it show? Generalization, right? So the wording of the ayah that came down was general. But who did it come down on? It specifically came down on Aws ibn Samit and his wife, Khawla binti Thalaba, رضي الله تعالى عنهما. May Allah be pleased with both of them. It came down on them. So, should we take the sabab al-nuzul which is khas, or should we follow the nas which is am, the text which is general? Which one should we follow? The Sheikh here is of the opinion that the text is for everyone. It's not just specific for who? Aws ibn Samit and Khawla bint Thalaba. It's not specific to them. Another example the Sheikh brought, another evidence that the Sheikh brought. No, sorry, he didn't, but I'll mention it. Which is the issue of the water. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the first hadith of Bulugh al-Maram, where Abu Huraira narrated, Ashab al-Sunan, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasai, all of them narrated it. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, إِنَّا نَرْكَبُ الْبَحْرَ وَنَأْخُذْ مَعَنَا قَلِيلًا مِنَ الْمَاءِ. O Messenger of Allah, we go and we mount on the sea. We go on the sea. We take little water with us. أَفَنَتَوَضَّأُ مِنْ مَاءِ الْبَحْرِ. Should we do wudu from the ocean, the water from the sea? Should we do wudu from it? The Messenger, he said, هُوَ الطَّهُورُ مَاءُ. He'll use a lafd am. He used a general term, which is ma'uhu. We just took that, which is mudaf. And we just took the idafa is min siyaghil umum. We just took it right now. But it came down on a specific situation, which was, he was asked about the wudu of the ocean, the sea, the water sea. Sah? That's specifically the question that was asked. But the answer he gave was general. Salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi. And then the Shaykh's opinion here, and the muhaqqiquna min al-usuliyina, the scholars of tahqiq in usul al-fiqh, including the author himself, they see an al-ibrata bi'umum al-lafd la bi-khusus al-sabab. They take the generalization of the wording and not who it came down on. Because they say, لِأَنَّ الْحُجَّةَ فِي اللَّفْضِ الشَّارِعِ وَهُوَ عَامٍ. The proof is in the wording of the legislation. As for the reason, it has no right to specify it. And their argument is that the companions understood it like that. The companions, they wouldn't specify, they would use a generality. Where would the Sahabas do that? Hadith of Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, that the Sahabas would take the generalization of the word. Abdullah ibn Ma'qalin, he said, Jalastu ila Ka'b ibn Ujrah. I sat with Ka'b ibn Ujrah. Who is saying this? Abdullah ibn Ma'qalin is saying, okay, I sat with him. فَسَأَلْتُ عَنِ الْفِدْيَةِ I asked him about the fidya. What fidya is he talking about? He's talking about the ayah, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ بِهِ أَذًى مِنْ رَأْسِهِ فَفِدْيَةٌ مِنْ طَعَامٍ مِنْ صِيَامٍ أَوْ صَدَقَةٍ أَوْ نُسُكٍ. So Allah says, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ, whoever from amongst you is what? I want you to ponder here with you. So the word man is used. Man is what? Shart. It's a condition here. Asma'u shart, what did we say? من سياغ العموم shows generalization. فمن كان منكم مريضا, whichever of you is sick, okay, أو به أذى من رأسه, or there is harm on his head, ففدية من صيام, he does fidya by fasting, أو صدقة أو نسك. In other words, a person is in Hajj, are you allowed to touch your hair while you're in Hajj? You're not allowed to, right? But if a person becomes sick from his head, he's sick, he has to cut his hair off, he can. ففدية من صيام أو صدقة أو نسك. Abdullah ibn Ma'qalin, he said, I asked him about this issue of the fidya. Ka'ab ibn Ujra, he said, نزلت فيا, it came down on me. Some nuzul is me. خاصة, specific came down on me. وهي لكم عامة, but it's general for you guys. إذا الصحابة رسول الله, they implemented what Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen is taking, أن محققون من الأصولين, which is أن العبرة من عموم اللفظ لا بخصوص السبب. When Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen mentioned that, he gave an exception. He said there's an exception here. He's not the only one who gave this exception. This exception also came from Ibn Daqiq al-Eid. Ibn Uthaymeen mentions, and before him, Ibn Daqiq al-Eid mentions in his kitab, إحكام الأحكام, which is a sharh of Umdatul Ahkam. This is one of the best books, if not the best book, on the explanation of Umdatul Ahkam, where they gave an exception, which is the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said to the man, لَيْسَ مِنَ الْبِرِّ الصِّيَامُ فِي السَّفَرِ لَيْسَ مِنَ الْبِرِّ الصِّيَامِ فِي السَّفَرِ. It is not from righteousness fasting while traveling. This is a general statement. The word as-siyam is general. It shows generalization. Al-istighraqi is in there. As-siyam, right? Al-istighraqi is in there. It shows every fasting. Whether there's hardship in it or not, it doesn't matter. It's general. Hey, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen here, he said, you don't take the wording. You look at what it came down on. Huh? He turned away from what he said, right? Rahimahullah ta'ala. He said that this hadith came down specifically on who? Specifically came down on a man who was fatigued. He was tired. He was so drained out that the people were shading him, and the messenger saw him, and the Prophet said, "Laysa min al-birri siyamu fi safar." It is not from righteousness fasting while traveling. He's talking about that man's situation. So Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen here is saying that it's talking about anyone who's like his situation. But why did he divert from him and Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid? Why did they divert from what they've already established, which is that the wording is followed and not the reason and where the context it came down on? The reason they said is because other external evidence showed that the Sahabas, they fasted whilst traveling. And the Messenger himself traveled. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen argued that in his point where he said, at the ending where he said, وَالدَّلِيلُ عَلَى تَقْسِيسِ بِذَلِكَ أَنَّ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَانَ يَصُومُ فِي السَّفَرِ. To show you that this is specific to this man, and anyone who's likely situation, is because he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he fasted while he was traveling. And if it was not from righteousness, the Prophet wouldn't have done it. So what we take from here is a very powerful issue, which is that the khususiyah is two types. The first one is called khususiyah to shakhsiyah, which is the one that I mentioned in the beginning. The one for Ka'ab ibn Ujra and the Aws ibn Samit and his wife Qawla binti Ta'laba. That's called khususiyah shakhsiyah. It personally came down on them. That type, which is the khususiyah shakhsiyah, it's general. You take the generalization of the wording. And the second type is the khususiyatun haliyah. The khususiyatun haliyah is like this man who was traveling and became fatigued and physically unable to fast. And the messenger said to him, "Laysa min al-birri siyamu fi safar." Laysa min al-birri siyamu fi safar. This hadith is specific to him and anyone who's like him. This is called khususiyatun haliyah. This one's specific. I will stop there inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.